Hello and happy Pi Day part two. I'm gonna do another coding challenge, and this coding challenge will be about visualizing the digits of pi. So I'm gonna use a file that I've prepared of 1 million digits of pi. I also will include links in this video's description to a file with 10 million digits and a file I think that has 1 billion digits. I can't remember which one I found, but various people have posted files with a lot more digits than I'm gonna use. So you might be interested in trying it out with even more digits, because boy, let's just make as many digits as we can. Now, this is inspired by two artists. Apologies for mispronouncing the names, but Martin Krasinski and Christian Vasil, who have made, Christian Elias Vasil, who have made a whole lot of beautiful images visualizing the digits of pi. So I encourage you to check out this Washington Post article. I'll link to that. There's also a wonderful number file video called The Beauty of Pi or something like that that I will link to that goes through some of their visualizations. I'm gonna try to do something really simple. So let's get started by loading those digits. So first what I want is I actually wanna have a string because I wanna take all the digits of pi and put them in a string. Although ultimately maybe I'll break that into an array of integers. But that's how they're gonna come in. They're coming in from a text file. So I'm gonna call it pi, just pi lowercase. I don't wanna say pi uppercase because that's a built-in constant in processing. Let's just arbitrarily have a window that's 400 by 400. Then I'm gonna say pi equals load strings. So load strings is a function that's part of processing. This is processing, by the way, a Java-based programming environment. That what it actually does is it loads, and I have a file, it's right here, pi-1million.txt. You can see those are a lot of digits in that file. So I just need to reference the file name. Here we go, file name. Now what this actually, I'm getting an error here. And what is that error? That error is type mismatch. java.lang.string, bracket bracket, does not match with java.lang.string. The reason why this doesn't match is the processing load strings function takes in your data into an array. And this is actually often quite useful, especially if you have data in multiple lines, because it takes every line from the text file and breaks it into an array. But this text file just has one line. So I can actually just take zero, just the first element of that array, and I'm gonna say print line pi just to see if this appears in the console. Ooh boy, I'm gonna freak it out because it should be a million digits there. Let's say pi.length to make sure I have a million digits. I forgot. In Java, length for a string is a function. I'm like, oh, I'm so used to programming in JavaScript. In Java, length for the string is a function. So I'm gonna say .length. And there we go. I've got 1 million digits of pi. We're cooking here. Now we're cooking. Okay, so let's actually break that into an array. So let me make an array called digits, which has 1 million spots in it. And I wonder if actually I don't need to initialize it, because I think I can say string, I'll call it sdigits, equals pi.split. And if I give it no, if I say split with no delimiter, so this is like splitting the string, but splitting it based on no delimiter, this should give me an array with a million strings in it. So I should be able to say, let's just see, sdigits.length. This is an array. So with an array, I don't need the parentheses because it's not a function. It's actually just the property of the array. Let's look at that. 1 million, 1 million. So I've got a million, and now I can, and then again, this is not necessarily the most efficient way. I can actually just, I think, processing has a function called int, which will just convert that array entirely into integers. So now if I say print array, and I probably am gonna overload the console here, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm gonna hit save, and I'm gonna run it. I now have, look at this. I am now printing the entire million digits of pi into the console. Just try loading the billion digits and printing it to the console. See how long that takes. What am I up to? Oh, I'm gonna get to a million before I finish talking. There we go. You can see on that last digit there is one. Okay, so now I have all these digits. What can I do? So many things, right? I could just fill the screen with all the digits. And I could be surrounded by the digits of pi. Now, I mean, in a way, I almost want to stop this now and say, hey, be creative, make something. I think what I'm going to try to do is visualize the frequency of the digits. So let's just actually make a simple line, right? Let's say they're 10 digits. So I'm going to go I equals 0. So I'm going to make an array called counts. And it has 10 spots in it, okay? And so, and then I'm going to also have an integer, which is like current digit, which will equal 0. So the first thing that I, actually current index, I'll just call that index. Because what I want to say is current digit equals pi digits index. And then I'll go to the next index. I got to worry about when I get to a million, but I'll deal with that later, right? So I can look at the current digit. Then I made something called counts already, and I could say counts current digit plus plus. So I'm going to increase the count for each current digit. And then what I will do is let's just draw a little, let's start with x equals 0. Actually, let's use I. I equals 0, I is less than counts.length, I plus plus. And I can do a little math here. I can say the width is the width of the window divided by counts.length. And so that's x is going to equal I times width, and y is going to equal just height divided by 2. So I'm just going to draw something in the middle. How about an ellipse? And I probably should offset it by half the width. So x, comma y, and I'm just going to draw some circles. Oh boy, let's get rid of that console, that print line. That's going to be a problem. Apologies, everybody. And I probably should make a smaller data file to work with while I'm developing this. But you can see, now I just got a whole bunch of circles. Now, what I want to do is actually let me make the size of the circle, relative to the number of digits there are. So counts index I. Why is that giving me an error? Float does not match with int. That's fine. Let's make this an int. So the more times, this should be an int. That's my problem. The index into the array has to be an int. I don't know why I put a float there. This can be a float because it can convert it. So now if I do this, what we're seeing is every time it finds one of those digits, it's growing that circle. Now they're just going to go bigger and bigger. And you can see, well, the distribution is somewhat even. Have I really discovered anything interesting here? I'm not so sure. Let's put these in the path of a circle. That'll be more interesting. So first of all, let me give this a background here. And let's think about this. So okay, so let's actually make, let's think about polar coordinates for a second. So I'm going to say angle equals map I, which goes from 0 to counts.length to between 0 and 2 pi. Pi is appearing now, right? I want to get an angle all the way around a circle. And then I want my x to be some radius. So like let's say 200 in this case, 200 times cosine of that angle. And this is me converting from polar coordinates, an angle and a radius, to Cartesian coordinates. I have a video about that that I will link to if this is unfamiliar territory to you. Y equals 200 times sine of that angle. And then let's also translate to the middle of the window, because I want to offset everything from the center of the window. And let's take a look and see what this gives us. So now you can see I have now put them all around them. This is digit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have normalized them in the path of the circle. So I don't know if this size is really that interesting. One of these artworks, if I scroll down here, actually what it does, and this it does it in a more sophisticated way, is it's connecting digits to the next digit. That would be super interesting to try. Let's try that. So I actually need to look at the next digit in this case, right? So I don't need to worry about this counts stuff. I actually don't even need to worry about this loop thing. Okay, hold on. Let's figure this out. Let me save this. I'm going to save this as pi day three, because I'm gonna rip this apart now for a second. So let me take this out. Let me get rid of all this count stuff. And let me say digit equals digits index, and then let me say next digit equals digits index plus one. So I'm gonna look at each digit and the next digit. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say angle one equals, and I might as well use the map function, digit which goes between 0 and 10, between 0 and 2 pi. I could pre-compute all these locations. Angle 2 is next digit. So now I just need to do that polar to Cartesian transformation thing again. I'm going to say 200 times cosine of angle 1, y1 equals 200 times sine of angle 1. I'll do the same thing for x2 and y2. Sine of angle 2, cosine of angle 2. And now, what if I draw a line from x1, x2 to y1, y2? So this is me looking at every digit, the next digit, mapping those points, taking those points around a circle and connecting them. Let's see what this does. Ah, beautiful! Guess what? The default stroke for a line in processing is black. So let's make the stroke 255. Ah, okay. So this is working, I think. Let's make the window a little bit bigger so that there is some. Let's draw a nice. Let's put move background to setup, and let's draw a little circle also. So let's say stroke 255. Let's grab the translate here also, and let's say no fill. I just want to draw a little circle so we can see that path. And I'm going to say 00, 200, 200. That 200 should definitely be a variable. And let's try this again. Oops. So the size of the circle is 400, 400, right? Because it's the width. So what have I done wrong here? Why are these points around a square pattern? The line function. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Probably everybody has been yelling at me when you watch this whole video. The lines are in totally the wrong place. x1, y1 to x2, y2. The line function takes the first point and the second point. And this is all messed up. OK. So now let's run this again. There we go. So now you can see that I am filling up the space. Now, honestly, all it kind of looks like is everything's connected to everything, which of course is the case. So maybe what I need to do is think about color, think about blending, think about those positions there. So, but you're seeing here some interesting possibilities here. So I haven't really made anything so beautiful. That wasn't the point of me making this video. The point of me making this video was to show you how to load all the digits of pi, how to iterate over them, and how to start thinking about drawing based on them. And if you look through and read this Washington Post article or think creatively on your own, I am sure you will come up with your own pi drawing. So please share pi train, I don't know, hashtag pi train on Twitter. Go to thecodingtrain.com and submit your, there'll be information there at the page for this coding challenge of how to submit your version of it. Share it with me on Twitter, share it with me in the comments. I would love to see your visualization of all of the digits of pi. So in the chat, I'm being told, oh, add some randomness, a little bit of randomness to those locations. That would certainly help. I guess I could do that before I leave. I mean, I'm not going anywhere, but like I could, and Gaussian randomness might be nice, but like what if I just say, let's add a little bit of randomness each time. Actually, the randomness should be in between whatever the difference between each angle is. So hold on. The difference between two angles is 2 pi divided by 10. So I want to pick something random in between there. Let's try that. Let's try that just to get a little something. And then let's make this stroke weight. Stroke, let's give it like some alpha. And now we can see, I don't know whether I've made anything better necessarily, but you can see this is like a variation on this theme. So you, the viewer of this video, are a more creative, visually talented person than I am. That I am sure of. So I don't want to go too far with this. I'm not adding any color. I'm not being thoughtful about those positions. The circular idea is just one idea. A grid is another idea. Somebody's suggestion making a skyline based on the digits of pi. There's so many designs that you could think about making based on the digits of pi. And another thing that I'm going to do in the next video is look at how to think about scale. So this is me just making it in a processing sketch. But what if I want to, it does kind of look like the moon, which is pretty interesting. What if I want to render out the digits of pi to a giant high resolution poster? So I'm going to look at that in the next coding challenge.